My name is Rhapsody. Welcome back to Hearthstone Arena. Off the back of that last episode, let's see if we can just play a stupidly overpowered class and then just play them stupidly well. So let's go mage. I feel like being an absolute scum bag. Okay. This is actually interesting in light of Crypt's very recent video on the subject, calling Grim Patron the worst rare in the entire rare set, except for... the worst rare in the entire rare set, sometimes even worse or lower ranking on a lot of arena websites than Ancient Watcher is, except for in the Mage deck. Apparently, in Mage, it's pretty good. Because it's 7 mana, you put it down, you ping it. I've had experience with it. I don't think it's that good. I think Knife Juggler is way better. So I'm going to go with Knife Juggler. Fuck it. I'm not going to go with the interesting pick. Who needs the interesting pick? It's too early to choose a Cult Master, and Harvest Golem is dope as fuck. That's always a Dark Iron Dwarf. Man, I'm really tempted to take the Worgen Infiltrator to try and get a turn up on my opponent. But Sorcerer's Apprentice is... No, I'm going to take the Infiltrator. I'm fine with this choice. I don't like Vaporize unless I'm summoning it for free using a Mad Scientist, so I'll take the Mind Control tech here. These are all bad. Which is least. So, an incredibly overcosted card, a 5-4, which should cost 4 mana, costs 6 mana instead. Or a Mogoshan Warden. I'm going to go with the Warden because I think I can actually possibly buff it and get attack. Or as long as I'm not too far behind, I'll be able to attack with it, ping. Like, it'll be a shitty version of an Oasis Snapjaw. Is that what I want? A shitty Oasis Snapjaw? No, I'll take the Priestess. It actually has to have... This has some board effect, whereas the other one can go by without having any effect whatsoever. Water Elemental is a Water Elemental, so I'll pick that, and that's a Flame Strike. Micro Machine is good so long as we're not playing it second, right? If our opponent has an established board and then we play it, it's a 2-2. But if we have if we establish it first and then our opponent plays something to respond, it's a 3-2, and then we get to trade against whatever we want. So I'll take it. Imp Master, statistically, just has the highest, so I'll take that. All of these are pretty bad. A 2-2, a 2-2, or a 4-2, which I'll take only because it has an instant board effect of removing a 2-2. Since I've got a Harvest Golem and a Micro Machine, it looks like the Goblin Blast Mage is actually going to be relatively effective, especially considering the Harvest Golem summons a Damage Golem, which is also a mech. Youthful Brew? Yeah, we'll take a Youthful Brew as... one of our 2-drops. Gilbin Stalker is another 2-drop, or a Gnomish Inventor. My 4s are currently really solid. Do need card draw. Alright, Gnomish Inventor it is. Ooh, Spider Tank. Love me a good Spider Tank. Especially consideration is given to the fact that I've got a Goblin Blast Mage and he'll most likely stick. Ogre Brute is just so fucking strong. On that slot, all of these are bad, so I'll take an Arcane Intellect. Not sure when I'll get time to use it. All of these are bad, so I'll take a Micro Machine. Not sure when I'll get time to... No, I'm kidding. I'll probably have time to use that. Raging Worgen. Maybe I get the Raging Worgen Dream off. So how many of my own things do I actually want to silence? Like, just Ogre Brute, right? So Wailing Souls is usually going to be bad. But I need things on the 4-drop slot rather than things on the 3-drop slot. So, well, I'm kind of stuck to it. Stranglethorn Tiger, because I need to get a little more late game, but I'm not sure I need to go that late game. Fairy Dragons, completely fine here. Piloted Shredder is one of the strongest 4-drops in the entire video game. Duplicate would be good if I didn't have such a low curve in the 1-2s, in the 2-3s and 4s. So I'll take a Frostbolt instead for immediate removal. Wow. I don't like this decision. I think it's possible I take Arcane Explosion. Is that dumb? I mean, I have no spell damage in my deck. Oh my god. Since it's so expensive, it's... Fuck it. I have to take Arcane Explosion. I can't use the other card. Oh my god, I wish I had a lot more 2/3s if I'm gonna pick the Shattered Sun. Still wanna pick the Shattered Sun though. Yeah. Just because of how many early drops I have. I could take the Ogre Magi to make my Arcane Explosion actually relevant. That seems dumb to me. How many spells do I have in my deck? 1, 2, 3. And then 4. Okay, so Mana Worm isn't going to be incredibly effective. And buffing it to a 2/4 with a Queen fucking Shattered Sun follow-up is just not at all a play that I want to think about. I might take Bloodsour Raider just because it's strong when I play the Shattered Sun on it. Becomes a 3/4, which then trades with 2/3s and 3/2s while surviving. Maybe Ogre Magi? Oh god. How many turn 2 drops do I have? So how many early drops, rather? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Except the Micro Machines can't be played first. Okay, fine. It's Bloodsour Raider. Oh, great. Now I've got to take a Snow Chugger. I wish I'd taken the Ogre Brute now. Gurubashi is so slow. So slow to get started. Even though you can ping it, it's just... And it's got the Kodo effect and all of those kinds of... I don't know. I'd be able to develop it earlier than the War Golem. God. Yeah, this is not good. This is not good. Okay, so if I'm gonna have to run out all of my early cards and be super aggressive, I'll take Jeeves. This deck is not good. A lot of our minions are okay. We've got a lot of good 3-drops, a lot of good 2-drops, a lot of good 4-drops, but then we kind of just go, oh, sorry, were we supposed to have things for the rest of the game? I totally forgot to draft those. I can't even complain about not getting offered them, because I did get offered a 4-stack max, I got offered a War Golem, I got offered... That's about it, but I did get offered a few heavier things that I totally turned down. Which I'm beginning to feel a lot like Christmas. I'm beginning to regret. Oh dear. Of course, I'm looking at this from the perspective of all of the arena streamers that I watch and how they'd be looking at that deck. It's possible that the strength of our early game just pushes us into victory regardless. None of those are good 2 or 3 drops. Since I have the coin, I would like good 2-drop followed up by good 2-drop. That looks good. Shattered Sun would be super fucking strong.
Is someone injured?
Well, this was probably going to be my play anyway, because I don't want to play it second after something else. If my opponent doesn't have a Power Word Shield or a Taunt minion, I just get to fucking eat that for free. And obviously, you know, it denies a lot of my opponent's card draw. Not having that Northshear. They also don't have the coin, so I don't have to worry about coin villains. Oh, man. Do I want to eat the Master Swordsmith instead?
Challenge accepted.
Yeah. So my opponent can super slow down by attacking here and then healing. Or they can... Worst case scenario is they Velens it and then kill something. Yeah. God damn, Velens is the strongest fucking card. The only reason to attack it this turn would be if I was super scared about getting Shadow Madness. Shadow Madness takes my Youthful Brewmaster and then runs it into here. Yep, heal. Heals it out of range of me killing it without attack ping. If my opponent doesn't develop another card, then attack, attack, ping. Blood Cell. It's not that bad. How many cards can I let my opponent take? I think I have to kill it this turn, actually.
Challenge accepted.
And then I play a minion to contest my opponent's. Hopefully my opponent doesn't have a really strong 5-drop minion, otherwise I'm in a pretty shitty position. Oh my god, if they play Kodo, I lose the game. Oh, do we lose? Already?
You gotta be kidding me!
You have to be kidding me! You gotta be. Okay. So now my opponent's gonna have a lot of difficulty summoning anything this turn. The only problem is, of course, if they heal it, I didn't think about that. Whoops. I totally didn't think about the possibility of them healing that minion. That was a misplay.
Who are you?
Okay, Dark Cultist. Water Elemental Ping. Strangthorn Tiger Naked. I'm gonna go with Water Elemental Ping because the majority of things that increase an opponent's damage only increase an opponent's damage by 2. Think Velen's Chosen, think Abusive Sergeant, think Dark Iron Dwarf. The majority of things that a priest has access to, at least. Shadow of Pain. The majority of things that a priest has access to, specifically. And I wouldn't be scared of that, you know, getting 5 attack, because that doesn't kill a water elemental. Not yet, at least. I can either play Gnomish Inventor, Spider Tank, Knife Juggler, Stranglethorn Tiger.
I wonder.
Knife Juggler, Stranglethorn Tiger. Stranglethorn Tiger threatens the Frost Elemental, but the Knife Juggler dies to the Frost Elemental. But it sets up my ability to kill the board. I don't think positioning matters right now, but I'll try. What if my opponent plays Nefarian and then gets Cone of Cold, right? Then it's going to be really important that my stealth is in the center so that my opponent can't Cone of Cold my entire board. Yeah, that's right. We're fucking playing meta now. The fuck?
Your magic shall not.
Thank you, Jamie Souls, for favoriting my tweet. But it has made my phone make a sound, which scared me. Probably one of the worst targets to get hit there, to be honest. I mean, I think they both just go across, right? That's gonna be frozen for another turn, though. Do I even need to deal with it? Yeah, I do. Well, draw a card first. Halves Golem or Spider Tank. Spider Tank is too easy to just be crushed by a dude. I still want to have a board after that crushes me. God, these priests with their health buffs. So fucking layabouts. Oh my god, how many quality cards do you want?
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Yay, trade without dying. And then establish something with a lot of hit points. Attack points, sorry. Now we're gonna run into an incredible amount of trouble if our opponent has Wide Removal or Mind Control tech. In either of those cases, we most likely just outright lose. Huh? Holy Nova? Thought Steal. These two cards are ours. Just remember that. That's one of ours. That is not. Summoning portal open. Flame Strike Arena off the top deck Arena. Oh. No Arena. Okay, so I want this to survive after it makes its attack, because this dies no matter what it attacks. So the only way this survives after making its attack there. Both of these die making their attacks.
Hey, give me a minute.
Oh well. Push forward. And I send the Fire Blast there to make sure that my opponent either has to heal it. Like, they're gonna have to use it to trade this turn. That's what I'm forcing. Since they only have three cards in hand, I'm not super worried about... God, Arcane Intellect's great. Well, since they only have four cards in hand... I wasn't super worried about the fact that this gets, you know, one less cost. But now I'm a little more worried about it, so yay. Here's hoping my opponent doesn't have the ability to remove the damaged golem, because I'd very much... Oh my god! Where's my Blast Mage? Oh, I have the perfect board. You must cleanse the sun well. This is the best board of all time. Shields up. Shields up. My opponent has shown no ability to deal one or two damage at any point. So leaving things on one and two health points is really good. So I'm going to very clearly leave everything on low health, because I don't believe, unless my opponent top decks it, that they have Holy Nova. Or Holy Smite, or fucking any two damage.
Behold the might of Stormwind!
Behold the might of Stormwind! Ragnostupid. Do you believe anything called love? Well, you could if you just listen to the rhythm of my heart. The way that the most things survive is if I attack here, ping here, and then attack this with this. Right, I forgot that it has health. Whoops. Well, I'm a dumb dude. Here's hoping my opponent doesn't have mind control. That is a very funny looking mind control. Oh, that's a good combo. I'm sorry. That totally whiffed.
I got this.
Hey, this is really good. Clear the board for basically nothing. And top deck Holy Nova or you're screwed. Got a total of 16 damage plus my hero power, so 17 damage when it comes back to me if I top deck Arcane Intellect into Frostbolt or Yeah, my opponent can heal. How did I forget that? Not playing Jeeves. No way, no how. My opponent has big swingier cards than I do. There is no way I am letting them get it. The Micro Machine by himself. Why am I gendering a machine? The Micro Machine by itself will be able to remove my opponent's entire hit points. Oh no. Oh no. One off lethal. So each and every one of the minions on my board poses a lethal threat to the Argent.
Ready to ride.
Yeah, you can only remove two of my things. And even after healing yourself, that Micro Machine is lethal. Well played.
Well played.
God, that was more stressful than it needed to be. See, that's an example of a game where our opponent got to play a lot of big minions, or even develop big minions using things like, you know, buffs. They got to develop and build a lot of big minions. We did not have a lot of big minions, so we had to keep running a lot of small minions and making very efficient trades. Getting that late into the game and getting into the top decking phase is horrible for us, because we don't just have that one card we can just bomb it down on the field and say, yo, suck this. We don't have that. We're going first, so if our opponent coins out a two, we are screwed. We have better two drops and three drops. I want some versatility in my two drop slot, but yeah, perfect. Perfect. I like it. Depending on what our opponent does with their first turn, we can decide whether to put down Micro Machine or Knife Juggler. If they coin out anything, basically, we don't Micro Machine. Yep, cool. It's Knife Juggler. Because if we put down Micro Machine, exactly, this is the circumstance that's the fucking horror situation. We put down Micro Machine in this situation. Our opponent, it gets to our opponent's turn. The Micro Machine is a 2-2. My opponent's 2-3 trades into it. They have a 2-1. I have nothing. Nothing at all. I get to ping on my next turn, and then my opponent develops another minion. They will have two minions over the top of us. It will be atrociously bad. What? Why? All right. Here's for the 50-50. No, 33%. Hit it. You're lame. Do I even need to trade? No.
Hey, catch!
Worst case situation is my opponent plays Rampage on this. And that would be hilarious. The first time I've seen Rampage in a long, long time. Yay! We managed to cheat three free damage in our opponent's face. Worst case scenario for us right now is that that Acolyte of Pain gets hit by a Cruel Taskmaster, drawing my opponent a card and creating this into a 3-2. Then that runs into my Piloted Treader. Oh, wow! The combos! Oh! My face is very sorry. I feel I run this into here, removing that as a threat, and then ping this. Giving my opponent a shitload of cards, but it also enables me to develop the Imp Master, and this stays alive. Yep. Gets me the most value for my cards. Especially since my opponent only has a 3-2 developed. So no matter what they kill on my field, if they want to keep that 3-2 alive, they have to attack something with one attack, which means that it ends up as a 3-1, which enables me to use my ping very effectively. That's a horrible target for an execute.
It's time for a little blood.
It's time for a little blood. Fine.
Silvermoon shall not fall.
Okay. Silvermoon is not going to fall, guys. Never. Did you think that Silvermoon was going to fall? Because I've got news for you. It's not. I mean, basically, my Imp Master is going to be trading perfectly against that. If you hero power, oh my god. I am the happiest dude that ever existed. Wailing Soul is okay, I guess. So that goes there. Ping, attack, I take two face damage, oh no. But I have an established board! Hey! I love it. I don't like that one. Oh, another execute! Yeah. It's worth noting that my Wailing Soul trades evenly for that. Oh, hey, definitely trades evenly for it now. Hit, See, my opponent drew 3 cards in the early game. How much deeper in their deck? 4 cards deeper in their deck than I am. And they're still losing. This is very important to note. I'm gonna flame strike the shit out of that board. You've been flame struck. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You've been thunderstruck. Cool. It only gains attack, buddy. I can still kill it so easily. Darkhand Dwarf makes the kill a lot easier. But it's possibly a good idea to just utilize my ping regardless. Is it? No, I want to develop the strongest ball that I can, and that's going to be playing both my 6 and 4, which means that I use that to trade. Hey, it also heals me back up a little to make up for that axe flinger that attacked my face while it died without getting value to my tiger. Oh, another one! Good fun!
What's the flight plan?
What's the flight plan? Admit it, my impression game for that one is on point. Totally.
I'm ready.
It's not necessary for me to play into mind control tech right now, so I'm not going to.
Done.
Especially since I should have lethal next turn regardless. Is that even correct? 4 from hand, 4 on board, 4 on board, 12, plus 5 makes it 17, which means that if I do get to hit face with all things and none of my minions are removed and my opponent doesn't play a taunt and they don't heal, except for armoring up, I win. Although they did remove 4 damage from my board. I will note, if I did develop the Worgen Infiltrator last turn, it wouldn't have helped anyway. Okay. And now it's very not important that I develop a fourth card. My opponent is also very specifically holding on to a few cards, so... Is that their third execute? Well played, by the way. Is that their third execute? That kind of explains why they were so willing to use an execute in the early game against a non-optimal target. Because they have 5 trillion. Their deck is just executes. The rest of them came out of unstable portals. I didn't see them play. And they couldn't play because they're the warrior class, but still. How many new shenanigans are going to be in Hysteria videos now that Nefarian allows you to steal the class-specific spells of a different class? I think that's going to be a real big thing. Not in the meta, but just in cool things. This is perfect. This is actually really fucking good. So I coin Micro Machine on turn 1, which means that no matter what my opponent plays on turn 2, it contests it, unless it's an axe, in which case I'm the saddest dude of all time. Wow! Our opponent is the lamest man. Okay. So our opponent just, stole a turn of our tempo. We could have had a Micro Machine on the board growing this turn, but no. Worst case scenario is our opponent... do I Frostbolt? No. Worst case scenario is our opponent develops something this turn, like a Race of Hand Hunter, which has 2 minions, or an Imp Master, which has 2 minions, and then both of those, for a 25% chance, both of those hit my Micro Machine and kill it. All that could happen. That's also a thing. Wrong! You hit the Micro Machine first, and then you get 1 free damage to face. Without, you know, luck on my opponent's side, that 2-1 will actually survive to kill something. So now my opponent summons a 4-drop minion. And hopefully hits my face. Dagger, dagger, hit my face. Dagger, dagger, hit my face. Fuck yeah! Whee! I can clear the board off the back of this. I cannot clear the board off the back of this anymore. Just hoping they wouldn't trade. It's actually really good. This forces the 3-2 to trade because the 2-2 axe, first off, doesn't kill it, and secondly, would be entirely tied up if it tried. God, the weapons! The weapons! Oh, having the hero power is really good for me. It means my opponent's gonna slow down. Oh no. Huh? Really annoying when the daggers actually fuck you. Like, really viciously fuck you. So I pinged that to try and entice my opponent to trade it in, rather than see it die to just another ping next turn. Of course. I mean, there's no other targets on my board, evidently, so it has to hit that rather than my face. I'm actually going to have to develop the Dark Iron Dwarf because I need to make sure that it hits the right target rather than using an Ogre Brute, which won't. God. I need Flame Strike. That's about it. Interestingly enough, Frost Bolting in the early turns wouldn't have mattered. Not that I'm aware of, at least. You need to miss. You have a 50% chance. Miss. Thank you. Now I need you to hit next turn. Well, miss and hit the wrong one next turn.
Done.
I am not a mortal.
Okay. Now that weapon is not allowed to hit my face. Zero face hits. I'm concerned that I played that, That was wrong.
Ready, sir.
Because now my opponent gets to draw a card from Acolyte of Pain regardless. Miss. Oh! Now I need this to hit. Well, it's got a 50% chance to hit. If it loses, if it misses that hit, I lose the game anyway. So, here we go. Fuck, lose the game. There's nothing I can do to kill the Silverhand Knight or heal my health points, so I just lose the game. Yes. Yep.
We must cleanse the Sunwell.
Well played.
Let me get that.
You win this.
Atrocious. Absolutely atrocious. Perfect. Only used weapons for the majority of the game to remove my minions. And then execute as well. Daggers and execute. I realized that some of those daggers went the way that I wanted them to go, like hitting the face in the correct manner and all of those types of things. So I realized the whole game was not centered against me. I realize I am only announcing the ones that go badly and not the ones that go well. I'm selectively choosing the data. I understand this, but at the same time, having all of those cards is still shitty. Oh, thank you for my one drop. Now my opponent plays arcane missiles and kill- No, they coin a bomber that kills it. Oh, saltiest dude of all time. Here we go. Coin. Bomber. Huh? Unstable portal gives mad bomber. Play mad bomber. No. Okay.
Put this apple on your head.
I'm gonna need more damage on the field, so I summon the 3 damage creature rather than 2 damage creature. And the reason I think I need more damage on the field is because of the possibility of my opponent having gotten, say, a 5 mana card from what they just used. Having gotten a 5 mana card and then using it. Engaging TC-130, mental dislocation. So this turn they can play a 6 mana card, considering that Unstable Portal makes the card that you get cost 3 mana less. They could play a 6 mana card this turn. God, 50-50 me. Outskilled. Pass me the arc light scatter. I've got that card back. That's the heroic card back. I should change that. I almost conceded while trying to change my card back. Marad, Lunar New Year. There we are, Nefarian.
Can I help you, sir?
Oh dear. That's not going to be good for you. I have a very low curve in hand. I don't even think I killed that. I was tempted to sacrifice my 2-1 into my opponent's 1-4. Just to play around mind control tech, but that's way too much. I'm also not far enough ahead in this video game to play that way. It's possible for my opponent to sacrifice their 1-4 into my 4-4. That's not that bad. Didn't kill my 2-1. It's fine. I'll actually keep both my Ogre Root and Freezer around.
First kill.
Will I? I can bounce this for card draw. I mean, I have to bounce something this time.
Hey, give me a minute.
No, I'll get all my card draw from Jeeves. So I'm not gonna try and attack with the Ogre Brute because there's a 50% chance it kills Jeeves and ruins the thing that I'm about to do.
Drink with me, friend.
Bounce you, play you. So now I get 1 card draw off of this. And I wanna be able to, like, this works into the way that I wanna play this anyhow. Cause my opponent still hasn't used coin, have they? Fuck, they could coin Flamestrike and win the game. I was about to say, I wanna get all of my little minions out before my opponent has Flamestrike, but I just realized it's entirely possible they still do. Whoops. Well.
My word is paramount. Leave me alone. Mm-hmm.
My work is paramount. Leave me alone.
Challenge accepted.
You know what? I think I still flood the board. Here's why. I had to develop something that turn to actually pose a threat to my enemy. And if I'm going to develop anything, I may as well continue developing because I just get the card back anyway. So I'm just utilizing the mana that I would eventually waste. Thanks, Ray. Definitely not as bad as it could have been.
We must cleanse the sun well.
And now I get 2 cards. There was a consideration given to the possibility of playing the Dark Iron Dwarf and then buffing it with the Shattered Sun, but that costs 7 mana. That would have evaded Flamestrike, but it would have evaded Flamestrike only in that my opponent would then run Jeeves into my Dark Iron Dwarf. It's fine. You gotta sacrifice that Jeeves now.
another ice lance?
I'll show them.
No.
I'll show them all.
Yeah, there's the sacrifice of Jeeves that I was expecting to see a lot earlier, to be honest.
I've got a huge...
Okay, I'll kill that. Summon Mirror Entity. Nothing. Oh, okay. And buff you and trade. I was wanting to play the Dark Iron Dwarf, buff that, and then run it into the Dark Iron Dwarf, but evidently not necessary. So this is a 10 mana Wind Fury. Sorry, 10 damage Wind Fury, by the way.
Pass me that arc light spanner.
That'll be hilarious. Opponent recognizes threat. Opponent neutralizes threat. Damn. Do I play my own Jeeves now? So Wailing Soul needs to go out first, no matter what I do.
Done.
Yeah, it looks like I play Jeeves. Oh. Okay, my opponent up until this point has not demonstrated having a second Flame Strike. It's also worth noting that I don't have that many cards that can play around Flame Strike. A lot of my four drops are four or five health. Five health is vulnerable to Flame Strike plus ping, which my opponent is in, you know, they're on turn nine or above, so they can do that. So it's not like I can just wait on a card and then use that card to win the game. I can't do it. I don't have cards for it. I am way overdrawing my opponent. Okay, what do we got on damage? Okay, four lethal.
Done.
Well played. Okay, we're almost at an hour. I'll cut. No. We're almost at an hour. I'll wait. We'll get to an hour. We'll play one more match. How's that? Seems like a good idea to me. Especially for a deck that curves so, so low. I wasn't expecting to have to die. I wasn't expecting to have to go into top deck as often as I have. I mean, it's not hugely aggressive. I just trade for a lot of value in the early
Gina
game.
Versus Gina.
Should probably angle this mic down. There we go.
My magic will
okay, I'm going first. Heart. This is actually a really good opening as long as my opponent doesn't have a one drop. No, I'm going first. This is a really good opening if my opponent doesn't have a coin too. Damn it! No! Hopefully the spider tank is strong enough to get me back into the game, or they don't have a coin too. That would be very important. Fuck. Why do I have to be such a dumb dude? Couldn't I just be a little less dumb of a dude, please? I feel like that would be really good.
Hello.
Oh. This is good. So, this trades for almost anything my opponent can generate this turn unless they coin a 3-drop. With a lot of health. We're gonna get this Goblin Blast Mage out, and it is going to goblin poop all over Jaina's face. If you're planning on double pinging a Micro Machine in the early game, first off, well, you have to make that decision very, very early because you don't want it to get out of control. Ping and then play a 2-drop? Is that 2-drop gonna survive to my mill house? Sorry, my spider tank? Oh. Really annoying. It was actually very effective. That was really effective. I'm almost offended at how effective that ended up being. In fact, fucked it. Fuck it. I am offended. I have to kill that.
I've got a huge
shit. You know, I should have killed this first, just in case it becomes Doomsail. Because then I would have known, don't play the fucking Stormpike Commando, you're gonna get killed. No wait, Doomsayer triggers on the start of my turn. I'm not certain what I would have done. Probably still not played the Stormpike Commando, to be honest. At least I have a board, but I have to play a mech in order to use the Goblin Blast Mage now. Of course it hits the right target. Flame Cannon has never done anything less.
For a little
Now three hit here, three hits here. I wasn't asking for four hits on it, I just wanted three. I feel that is relatively okay to ask for, especially when my opponent 50-50s their fucking flame cannon correctly. Is there a better play that turn?
I wonder
if it's possible that I wanted to get the Wailing Soul out way before I summon the Micro Machine, just in case. Because now it's kind of just bogging down the hand. Top deck Flame Strike. Ooh, there it is. I think I do just as much draw as I can this turn. Arcane Explosion is good, but not enough. Hang on. Arcane Explosion, ping, attack, kill. That's actually really good. It lets my 3-2 trade up while it's not going to die to the Squire, and sets up the Squire for a ping next turn as well. It also leaves my Goblin Blast Mage. Well played. It leaves my Goblin Blast Mage out of range of the Squire, plus a Fire Blast. It's also worth noting, probably one of the only circumstances where I'm actually going to be able to use, effectively, Arcane Explosion. So I may as well use it in that situation when viable. Run the 2-1 into it. The correct move to do. No. Worst case scenario is my opponent flame strikes and I'm left with a 2-1. Actually, worst case scenario is they flame strike, I'm left with the 2-1, and then they develop a 1 mana creature like a zombie chow. That's actually a pretty bad case scenario. They've used the coin, right? Yeah, they've used the coin. They used it to ping and flame cannon on turn 3. Okay. God, I really need to keep track of the coin more often so that I don't get into top deck walls with someone and then I play around the one card in their hand and oh, it turns out it's actually not a card. It's useless. God. Good Wailing Soul so that I can attack. Oh, baby. Girabashi is good. Makes my board less vulnerable to Flame Strike. This is going to die this turn anyway, so like that ping happens, and then if a Cone of Cold was going to happen, it's going to hit all three other targets anyhow. Fuck me! God. Why? At least I can kill it. The problem, by the way, is that killing it requires a huge investment from me. Like, I ping it, which means I can't ping this and run this in. I need two pings this turn, that's the problem.
I wonder.
I am the blade.
I'm not gonna play Blood Cell. Okay. I've still got my Flame Strike, so this is really good. The problem is my opponent is very unlikely to just suddenly play a lot of minions. Hopefully when I use my Arcane Explosion, it told them, oh, he doesn't have Flame Strike in hand. And for that specific reason,
what to do?
They didn't care about playing around it. That's possible. That's a call I might make. Which means, you know, a wrong call. I can't see myself flame striking those.
Hey, give me a minute.
I'm gonna play slow. The thing is, if I develop the Wailing Soul this turn, you turn around with your 5-1 and you kill my Wailing Soul. You just do it. So I lose the card and my opponent loses their 5-1. But they're going to lose their 5-1 this turn anyway.
Cleanse the sun well.
Excellent. Develop a bigger board. Two more minions.
A fight! Count me in! Everyone! Get in here!
Mine and dead.
Mental dislocation!
Well played.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Now I have to ping my own Grim Patron as soon as possible. Start summoning more. Fair. It's fair. Wrong order. Oops.
Whoops.
I have stolen their patronage. The really important thing, by the way, about that play is that Grim Patron is a, if you can't deal with me, I will win the game card. Okay, do I want to use a Frostbolt? Or do I want to sacrifice my minion? Frostbolt. It's closer than you'd think, though. Eleven damage next turn. I just need to top deck my Pyroblast. That I didn't draft. I need to top deck it from someone else's deck. So I need to top deck it from their deck. What are you setting up for? Flame strike?
My eyes are open.
I am suspicious. Possible that I should have put the armor plating onto my 5-5 so that it's not vulnerable to be flame struck and then pinged. But I don't think my opponent has a flame strike, that's the thing. Unless it's from the top deck. I'll face this manipulator. What are those other two cards in hand that my opponent refuses to play? They have to be cards that are entirely irrelevant to the situation. Well, of course, spare part that they hadn't used yet.
Me smash you.
Well, looks like I'm trading there. Against Flamestrike, the armor plating is entirely ineffectual right now. It saps 2 mana from my opponent, basically. Flame strike from the top deck, of course.
Well played.
Drink with me, friend.
Flame strike from the top deck. Well played. Good work. Very proud of you for drafting those. Flame strike again. Okay. Now I'm going to use the armor plating because my opponent is clearly trying to ping this over a series of turns. And armor plating it will slow that down. It's also worth noting that if both of these survive, my opponent doesn't play a taunt, my opponent doesn't heal.
Well played.
I win the game.
Well played.
I'm assuming they're not bad mannering me. I'm assuming they're about to concede. Not relevant to the video game.
You might feel a little tingle.
Not relevant to the video game. We win.
My magic will tear you apart. My magic will tear you apart. You win. Well played.
Okay, 4-1. And 57 minutes in. Not only do we earn a golden polymorph, but we cut to a part 2. You'll be able to find the link to part 2 in the description down below, and we'll hope to see you there.